Hey guys, welcome to my latest radio restoration nightmare. This radio I just bought on eBay. It's a 1946 Air King All-American 5, and it was in far worse shape than I thought it was by looking at the pictures in the ad. Truth be told, this thing is so rough that I should just pull the few good parts that it has on it and throw the rest in a dumpster, but I thought I'd give it just one chance at life before I do that. Maybe I'll wind up restoring it. You know, there's so much wrong with this radio, I actually had to write it all down so I didn't forget it all. First of all, it wasn't packed correctly, so it arrived with this nice big crack in the side. That's lovely. And you can see there's like a bunch of white shit all over the cabinet here. That didn't really show up in the pictures in the ad, so I didn't know it had all that. Turn it around here. I do like the styling of this set. That's what drew me to it. You turn it around again here. Notice how there's a darker area on the cabinet, like right in this area in here. You notice that? I believe that's mouse piss. It's, like I said, it's darker than the rest of the cabinet. It's sticky. So the cabinet's pretty much a wreck. But if we go over to the chassis, things don't improve much more. The chassis also had a bunch of that, you know, a layer of that thick goo on it, that mouse piss, and it was also far rustier than I thought it would be. I sanded a lot of it off, and you can see there's still quite a bit of it left behind. Like I said, just a 5-tube model, nothing fancy here. Let's see. Let me show you the lovely power cord that came with it, this crumbly, gooey mess. Oh yeah, that's still UL listed, right? And if I turn it around here, there's the front, and the dial cord was broken, so I had to rewind that, and the actual tuning shaft itself was frozen. All the old grease in it had frozen, so I had to work with that. And like I said, I decided that, you know, against all common sense, I'm going to give this radio one chance at life. If it plays, then maybe I'll restore it. If not, it's going to get parted out. So in order to find out whether it was worth restoring or not, there were some things I had to do to it. First of all, it got a new power cord. Second of all, he restrung the dial cord and freed up the tuning shaft so that everything turns nice and freely now. If we go underneath here, I gave it some new filters, and I think I replaced one paper capacitor simply because it was in my way, so I figured while I was in there, I would go ahead and do that. But yeah, that's it. In the next video, I'm going to put it on a dim bulb tester and power it up, and we're going to see if this thing lives or if it gets thrown in the dumpster.